Hello, Vinny from Guitar here, and we are in our lovely acoustic room at the Guitar Epsom store in front of the Taylor Wall for very good reason. Today we're going to be talking about this, and this is a brand new release from Taylor. This is the Taylor American Dream 22E, or AD22E for short. Now, it hasn't been that long since the American Dream's first launch. It's a fairly new range in Taylor's line. The American Dreams set out to be playable, more affordable guitars with all of the tone of a solid wood acoustic. And we first seen that in the new AD17s, which again, I said, came out quite recently in the grand scheme of things. And these are based on Taylor's Grand Pacific range. And now we have this, the AD22E. This is the first time they've done a different shape in the American Dream range. So this is a Grand Concert shape. It's quite small, it's not a huge body, but this thing is packed full of tone. And we'll talk a little bit more about why that is. So combined with the Grand Concert shape, this has got a solid mahogany top and solid Sapele back and sides. What we generally find with mahogany topped acoustic guitars in this kind of shape is that you get a lot of mid-range from these. They are very warm and they have a lot of depth in those frequencies. And it also rounds off a little bit of that high-end bite that you would get out of something like a spruce top. What that means for you as a player is this is a guitar which is extremely responsive when it comes to finger picking and mellower playing styles. So if you're into your folk music and you like that sort of playing, then it's really great for that. But this isn't just a one-trick pony, it is a Taylor after all, and if you are even somewhat familiar with Taylors, then you already know that Taylors are always very comfortable and very playable. So in line with the rest of the American Dream range, these have got these nice smoothed edges, and I mean, it just feels really good in your hands, especially, you know, if you're a finger picker, as I've already mentioned, and you just need that comfort and you need to feel really in control of your guitar. This is really, really nice for that. Again, very much in line with a lot of what we've seen from Taylor in recent years. This has got the V-class bracing system. So inside of the guitar, generally speaking, most acoustic guitars for years and years have used some form of X bracing. Taylor in the last few years have very slowly but surely been putting this V-bracing in most of their ranges. The idea with the V-bracing is that it holds the top up in a slightly different way from those more conventional X patterns, so it allows the top to move in a slightly different way. That basically means that you're getting a lot more sustain and a lot more volume from these guitars. So all of these Taylors with the V bracing, they are generally much more responsive, and you do really feel those frequencies when you play them. Just really, really nice, and it totally makes sense that they've put V bracing in these new AD22Es. As I've already mentioned, guitars of this shape and design are usually best utilized in a kind of finger picking sort of playing style, and the scale length also adds to that. So the scale length on this is 24 inches and 7/8. So what that means for you, by having a slightly shorter scale length, it means that the strings are slightly slinkier at tension. So when you're doing your finger picking, the strings are just a little bit softer on this end, and it just makes it a little bit easier on your playing experience. Again, this is a Taylor, so it's got the very comfortable Taylor style neck. It's got the ES2 pickup system. Absolutely love these pickups. They're some of the best acoustic pickups I've ever heard. Just sound so much like the actual guitar, not some honky piezo that they've just put under the strings. It gets a lot of the body woods tones. So one of Taylor's big messages is always the kind of find your fit, find the right acoustic guitar for you. You know, there's so many options in terms of tone woods, body shapes, just so many different ranges. And it's such a shame when people spend so much time finding the right guitar for them, and then when they plug them in, it just sounds nothing like the guitar that they've bought. Taylor's Expression System pickup makes sure that when you're plugging these acoustics in, they still sound like the Tonewood that you have bought, and that is so, so nice. And this is nothing new. Taylor's have had these for years and years. But what's the point of all of this talk about a nice solid mahogany top on a guitar like this and then plugging it in and it just sounding like, you know, any other electroacoustic guitar? So glad that this is in this. Taylor just understand what an electroacoustic needs to sound like, and yeah, gonna stop talking about it now. In Taylor's own words, the AD22E has been made to fit a workman-like aesthetic, so there's no cutaway. It does feel a lot more like a vintage acoustic guitar than most Taylors usually do. I do think a lot of that is down to it being part of the American Dream series. Taylor obviously wants to kind of do something a little bit different to what they normally do in most of their other ranges with the American Dream. Taylor's entire building process is very modern, and I suppose a lot of the time their guitars match that process. And that's not a criticism at all. I absolutely love Taylor's, but it is also very nice to see a guitar that looks like this in a Taylor range. It's got all of that vintage look and feel, but it still does have all of the comfort and playability of a Taylor. Generally speaking, if you bought a guitar like this from maybe some other brands that make guitars like this, not naming any names, you might find that it's a little bit more work to play. That's not to criticize those guitars. It's just a fact of Taylor's. They're very playable acoustic guitars. They're almost like playing electric guitars in terms of the neck and the action, and that is very intentional on Taylor's behalf. As important as specs are in a video like this, I do think it's just worth touching a little bit more on just how this guitar feels, because I've already mentioned a lot about how Taylor's are very modern, but this is a little bit more vintage inspired. And I guess one of the main questions that people might ask is, well, if Taylor is so good at making modern guitars, surely this isn't going to be as good. And that is definitely not the case. I think it's very important to say there has obviously been a lot of thought and care put into this guitar. The AD22E is such a well-balanced guitar. I'm not gonna say that this is great for playing big, loud chords. If you wanna do that, look at the AD17s. They're kind of on the other side of the spectrum on the American Dream range. This is perfect for those finger-picky, kind of rootsy, mellow vibes, and it does it so, so well. Again, I keep saying this, but to be able to have a guitar that produces the sound like this does, to have the look that this does, but also have the playability that this does, that is really, really hard to come by in a lot of acoustics. Generally, you're going to have to compromise on something, and this definitely ticks all the boxes, and we are absolutely loving this for that reason alone. And one last thing to mention, in terms of a case, this comes with one of Taylor's Aero Case gig bags. These are very, very padded, high quality gig bags. We've been talking about this a little bit in some of our other videos. More and more, we're seeing people cry out for super sturdy gig bags over hard cases, just because they're easier to carry, they're nicer to store. And the cases that come with this are amazing. We've already seen them in some of the other American Dream ranges. I think they also use the same style case on the GS Mini Pluses. Just really, really good for carrying these around. Obviously, you're gonna wanna protect this, and yeah, great from Taylor. But it's not all about what we think. We want to know what you think. So the Taylor AD22E, do you love it? Is there a question you'd might like to ask before you make your mind up on it? We are always, always here to answer any of your questions, whether that be in the comments below or you can get on our website, guitarguitar.co.uk, and there's a little chat box in the corner which has actual real Guitar employees on the other side. You can talk to them, you can ask them questions about any of our stock, not just these, and yeah, just have a chat with them. But if you're more into face-to-face interactions and you want to come to one of our shops and play on one of these, we have a huge collection of experienced sales staff who would be more than willing to answer any questions you have on these or any other guitars. Once again, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more content from us, please do feel free to hit the subscribe button, hit that little bell so you can get notifications from us too. We are always uploading new videos about new guitars, just like this one. So hopefully see you again soon. Until next time, see you soon.